Welcome, Dr. Glass.
Oh, I'm so happy to be here, Connie, because I'm a big fan of yours.
Thank you. And this book should help more people. The minute I read it, I said, I've got a niece, I've got a cousin. They
exactly.
need this book.
Exactly, for relationships. And even if you're a man, it is not about male bashing at all. It really is about helping people learn to heal from relationships that may not have been that favorable. And so many people need this.
Absolutely, including, let me say, that in the beginning is 11 toxic types.
Yes.
And let's talk about the jealous competitor, because that's not unlike, as an analyst once said, the whole narcissist complex. They see themselves in your eyes as being bigger than they really are, and they take that away, but they take part of you away. So you are depleted.
That's right. They minimize you to maximize themselves.
Yeah.
But the main thing is, this is such an important thing, because when you find somebody in your life that's competitive with you, it's very unhealthy, because that leads to toxicity. It leads to envy. It leads to jealousy. It leads to even violence. So people need to be aware of that.
And that's even maybe a little different from narcissists, though, isn't it?
Yeah, there is somebody that's in one of the toxic types, or the me, myself, and I narcissist.
Yeah.
The one who's always talking about themselves. It's me, 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 me. So that's real different than the jealous type, because the person who's competitive.
And the other is the one you really run away from is a sociopsychopath.
Yeah, those are the people that there's no hope. You just, when you see that coming, run as fast as your feet will carry you.
And then there's the part for young women who may be working for, well, the ideal man, they think, but he's married.
Yeah, and that's a problem. That is a big problem, and unfortunately it affects people's self-esteem, and it's not a great idea.
Yeah, I mean, at least, you know, we see it on TV with the people who were in the 40s and 50s and average. But nowadays, between the pill and the way marriage has not become the end-all be-all, a married couple are fragile.
Yeah, they are fragile. A married couple is fragile. And when you look in some communities, one out of every two are getting divorced, one out of every one. And this is a way people can heal with each other.
Yeah.
And that's what's so important, communication.
But what if he's suddenly feeling his oats, so to speak, and wants a flirtation?
Well, you know, there, one of the things I talk about in the book is that there are 10 ways of dealing with people who are difficult or make your life miserable. And you have options. And sometimes you can communicate about it. Sometimes you can let it go. And other times you can let the person go, depending on what it does to you.
Because often you almost have to see, where am I in life?
Exactly, because people are in different places. Somebody who may be at a certain level in their career and in their life may feel differently than another person.
Yeah. Somebody comes into your life, and you talk about it here, about guests.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, it's kind of like we are all guests, and we have to treat people with respect and dignity. And that's the message throughout the whole book, to really treat people with dignity and respect.
Yeah, and you have to learn how to forgive yourself.
That's the first thing, and to forgive others. And sometimes there are people that do things that are unforgivable, that you can't forgive, and there's nothing wrong with that. And in those cases, you need to let them go out of your life and really let them go physically,
mentally. What are some of the strategies to help rebuild your life?
There's so many strategies to rebuild your life. There are things that you can do to pamper yourself. We need to be nurtured, especially we've gone through a traumatic relationship. We need to take care of us. If you want to eat that chocolate cake, do it. Go for it. Feel good. Be around people that love you. Be around people that care about you. Be around people who say wonderful things to you. Go out and try new things, things you've never done before.
But what about when that person is suffering and they bore everybody else with, what did I do wrong? And maybe he'll come back.
Right. That's expected. And a true friend will listen to you. They'll understand that, because it doesn't last forever. And that's why they're great therapists to help you get through that.
Yeah.
But sometimes you need those friends. You need those shoulders to cry on.
And the first sign of anybody raising the hand to you,
get out the door.
Yeah.
Run like your hair's on fire. Don't even look back.
But that's the one who says, oh, it was my fault. I asked for it.
No, this is abuse. And there's a lot of things that people don't even realize that are abusive, like how a person teases you or how they talk to you or if they talk down to you. And this is unacceptable. Verbal abuse is abuse.
Yeah. Yeah. That's a very sort of pinpoint thing.
Exactly, because people don't realize, you know, you can say to somebody, yeah, here, have another donut, you wear it well. No, I was only kidding. You know, there's no joke in that. There's hurt feelings, and that's not acceptable.
Sex for a couple that have been together for a while, and how to keep it alive.
Communication. Again, what going to each other, communicating, and going into each other's boundaries and letting them know that maybe you're going to cross the boundary a little bit, but keeping it exciting.
Yeah. Let me say, can there be a toxic woman who brings out the toxicity in the man?
Absolutely, and I talk about this in the book because they're called lethal combinations. If you get a woman who's very aggressive, or a man who's very aggressive, and then you get the other party who's very kind of a silent but deadly type. You know, they're kind of very low-key, and then all of a sudden they blow up at you. That's huge, and that's a very big mismatch.
Lillian, with all of these stories in here, do you write screenplays or plays?
It's funny that you said that, Connie, and only you could say that because of your background. Yes, I wrote a screenplay for Toxic Men, situation comedy. Actually, it's more of a romantic comedy, and it's... I'm really excited about it, and it's being seen by some people right now, but it's so exciting because I think it gives a great message.
Yeah. Well, I mean, here they are, you know, it's all in this book.
It's all in this book, and it's so there, and it's really not about being a victim anymore, because so many women, you know, we see this on the news all the time. We're reading about some celebrity or another, and he's done something, and we're going, oh, no, how could she be with him? But people have to realize that it doesn't matter what your race is, your background is, your age. Everybody gets exposed to somebody, how wealthy you are, how poor you are. Everybody is not immune.
And it's not easy in a world where actors and people who are celebrities have their way.
Exactly. And when we let them get away with a lot of things, and some of them feel entitled.
Now, let me go to the angry, bullying, control freak.
Oh, yes. There are a lot of those. I guess we've heard a lot about that on the news with Mel Gibson, kind of the angry, bullying person who's, it's their way or the highway. And if you live with a person like that, that could be very dangerous.
And also the feeling that any minute, you don't know when they're going to explode.
No!
And even if you're driving with them, the chance of having an accident
is very high.
Yeah.
And you really have to be so careful when you're around these bully types because they are so dangerous. And there are ways to combat them, and that's what I talk about in the book.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can diffuse their bullying.
The other is, how about giving this book to people who are getting engaged?
It should be given to everybody who's engaged, who's married, and who is in grade school. I think people need to read this because then they'll have a good sense of self when they're young girls and even young boys. That is so important. We have to educate our children. And unfortunately, it's not being done in the homes. It's not being done in the schools. Somebody has to do it.
And how much will you put up with before you say enough is enough?
I think people realize that they don't want to hurt each other's feelings or another person's feelings. They want to just, you know, let it go. Maybe it'll change. It won't. You must set boundaries. And I teach you how to do that.
Yeah, you certainly do, Lillian. But let me just say, give me one example for our friends in the audience.
In terms of?
Of teaching how not to put up with it.
Well, for example, you can, if somebody is saying something, you can just stop and say, take a breath and go, you know, what you said is very hurtful. It hurts my feelings. You don't have to blame them. I don't like what you did. I don't like what you said. But, you know, it's very hurtful to me. And maybe you didn't mean to say that. But I just wanted to let you know how it came across.
And he says, gee, you're too sensitive.
And then you say, you know, I am sensitive. And I hope you appreciate that about me. Because I appreciate your qualities. So sensitivity is mine. So let's deal with that.
And in that case, better read the book.
Lillian, thank you.
Thank you. Will you autograph my book? My pleasure.
Oh.
And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.ConnieMartinson.com. You can read our columns from the Beverly Hills Courier. You can see some of the older shows and the more recent shows if you go to our channel on YouTube or link up to Claremont Graduate University Peter Drucker Institute. Meanwhile, support your local library, because libraries are our finest democratic institution. And thank your librarian, because he or she saves democracy by keeping books alive. And we'll see you next time.
Oh, truly, you're wonderful. Thank you, Connie.